Everyone in some way, either a family member, friend, or personal struggles. And according to the CDC, 38 people die every day from overdoses involving prescription opioids. Here to tell us more about addiction and tips and prevention is Nurse Christina Paris. Good morning. Thanks so much for being with us.
Good morning.
This is like obviously such a very intense topic. So what is addiction and how does somebody become addicted?
So addiction, you know, according to the American Society of Addiction Medicine, is a treatable chronic medical disease involving complex interactions between brain circuits, genetics, and the environment. So there's a lot that goes on to it. It is very complex. So if you think of the brain, and it kind of makes this C shape, so we have the frontal cortex, or the prefrontal cortex, and that's the part of our brain that deals with judgment, decision making, self-regulation, and it kind of guides our behavior. And then right kind of after that, if you think of a C shape, there's the striatum. Now that is our motivational system. That's the part of our, it's actually in our brain, but part of our motor system. That's what really drives us and causes us to act. And then right kind of underneath that, at the bottom part of the C, would be the midbrain, and that is a dopamine pump. So that actually is what kind of gives the fuel to drive the action. So what happens usually is we have these constant communication between the prefrontal, so the very front, you think kind of your forehead, and sort of the back part of the striatum. And we communicate, so we see stuff and we enjoy stuff, and so that's what drives us to do it. Hmm. Now, most of us, we can, you know, go past a candy dish. For me, it's sugar, you know, and kind of go, I'm hungry, I might want something. Now for others, it's that pull to want to grab that sugar, or for people who are addicted to drugs or alcohol, just driving past maybe the liquor store might drive your brain to go, oh, let's go in there and I need that. So that's it. There's a lot of complex things going on.
And what are some warning signs of addiction?
So a lot of some of the warning signs, you know, are going to be a lack of control. You're going to have difficulty, with relationships. You're going to maybe miss important obligations. You're not going to feel sorry for your actions. You're sort of going to be apathetic about it. Chronic fatigue, increased secrecy, unexplained injuries, hair, it can affect your hair, your skin, your teeth, your nails, changes in speech, mood. Sometimes people become aggressive, and even depression can occur.
Oh my gosh.
So yeah, there's a lot that can go on. And it's such a strong pull and such a strong desire for these behaviors.
Yeah. So of course, again, this is such an intense topic. So what can, you know, we do to possibly prevent addiction?
So prevention, a lot of it, starts with us as a community, reaching out to people, not treating people as if they're bad or delinquents, but really showing some care. Talking about addiction, you know, talk to your kids. I can't tell you how many times when my kids were little and they'll tell you, oh yes, we got death by lecture, they joke about. But honestly, I would talk and talk and talk, and I can even remember things my parents would say about smoking, like, you know, and it kind of, you know, mom's voice kind of comes back in your head. But yeah, to talk to your kids, lead by example, provide clear rules and expectations, and spend time with your children. Promote positive interactions with your kids. Let them know that they're valued and they're worthy.
Yeah, well, those are really, really good tips, and the positivity within it. It's such an intense situation. I think it's very important because that can hold people back from talking about
Absolutely.
It.
So really, absolutely. Yeah. If we think of them as being, you know, a negative side of society, and that's really unfortunate because they're so worthy of love and care.
Absolutely. Well, thank you so much. We love you. There's Christina. So happy to have you here.
Thank
of course,
you.
We'll see you next week.
Thank you.